Ian Brady is still among us. We have just learned that Moore's murderer Ian Brady's remains still haven't been disposed of. Welcome back to True Crime News. So glad to have you aboard. If this is your first visit, please remember to slap that follow button. This is your host, Ted Corner speaking. Let's jump right into the news. It has come to light that Moore's murderer Ian Brady's dying wish has been refused. The twisted serial killer wanted a symphony about a satanic orgy played at his funeral. It was actually to the sounds of Hector Berlioz's symphony, Fantastic, Brady wanted to be buried. The symphony is a piece the composer described as a witch's Sabbath, where hideous monsters gathered to laugh at a funeral. Ian Brady died aged 79 on May 15th, but the notorious child killer's remains have not yet been disposed of. To the odd burial wish from Brady, Judge Sir Jeffrey was told it would have caused legitimate offenses and ruled that his body should be lowered into the ground with no music or ceremony. Besides, he said, Mr. Marking didn't suggest the deceased had requested any other music to be played or any other ceremony to be performed. Sir Jeffrey was asked by two local authorities to make decisions relating to the disposal of Brady's body so the serial killer can be lawfully and decently disposed of without further delay. Oldham Metropolitan Borough Council and Thameside Metropolitan are concerned that 5 months after Brady's death, his executor, Solicitor Robin Marking, had failed to make proper arrangements for the disposal. It is believed it's necessary to take the matter of the disposal of Brady out of Mr. Marking's hands if the deceased body is to be disposed of quickly, lawfully and decently. But after a hearing that has lasted for 1.5 days, the parties have not been able to agree precisely how the deceased body should be disposed of. After Ian Brady died, coroner Christopher Sumner said he would not release the child killer's body until he received assurance that his ashes would not be scattered on Saddleworth Moor. Previously, there has been rumors that Ian Brady had requested his ashes to be scattered at the very same place. We have a video about it. We will leave a link to all our Brady videos on the screen and in the description. The idea of Brady's ashes to be scattered at the very same place he buried his victims would be a sick and twisted act to give the families of the victims more misery. At the time, there were talk about this. Terry West, who is the brother of murder victim Leslie Ann Downey, said it would be the final act of twist by an evil man. And as the coroner ordered a ban of Brady's ashes being scattered on Saddleworth Moor, it must have been more than just a rumor. Mr. Marking has refused to reveal the killer's funeral wishes. Marking has not been justified in being so secretive about how he was intending to dispose of the deceased body. But if he had discussed the matter openly and given clear he was not intending to scatter Brady's ashes, the proceedings could possibly have been avoided. Even now he refused to say what he intends to do with the ashes if he is allowed custody of them. Therefore, he cannot be trusted with the ashes for disposal. However, during a hearing, the local authority tasked with disposing of Brady's remains said it would be done expediently. It is understood that before his death, Brady requested his ashes to be scattered in his native Glasgow. But so far, no funeral directors willing to handle his remains has been found. Glasgow councillors have also refused to let either of the two crematoriums take on the job. Taxpayers is expected to pay for the bill for his funeral and cremation, as Brady is not thought to have any living relatives. A judge from the High Court concluded, taking into account all the competing positions, the overwhelming factor in this case is the public interest. The deceased's wishes are relevant, but they do not overweight the need to avoid justified public indignation and actual unrest. In the meantime, Brady's body is left in a mortuary at a secret location. When Hindley was cremated in 2002, the prison service tried 20 local funeral directors who all refused the job before eventually booking a firm based 200 miles away. Ian Brady and his partner Myra Hindley, who died in prison in 2002, tortured and murdered 5 children in the 1960s. In the beginning, the killer couple admitted to killing 3. John Kilbride, 12 years, 10-year-old Leslie Ann Downey, and Edward Evans, 17. But later they admitted the murders of Pauline Reade, 16 years, and Keith Bennett, 12. 4 of the victims were buried on Saddleworth Moor in the South Pennines. The only victim who wasn't buried there was 12-year-old Keith Bennett. His body has never been found, despite a long-running campaign by his mother, Winnie Johnson. Brady died in his room at Ashworth Secure Mental Hospital, Merseyside, at around 6 p.m. An inquest last month heard that the serial killer remained a narcissist and control freak until the end, removing the nasal tube used to feed him while on hunger strike himself 5 days before his death. When we receive news about Brady, we will give you an update. Remember to subscribe to our channel for more true crime news. Don't miss out on all the true crime articles we share with our community. Make sure to subscribe to our other social media sites. If you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. For your viewers, remember to subscribe and click the bell. See you in the next video.